For centuries, man has felt the charges of static electricity. Since the discovery of the electron, we have known that the cause of this electrical charge is the negative electron. But even before this was discovered, much was known about the electrical charge or static electricity. The study of static electricity is called electrostatics. The laws of electrostatics describe the attraction and repulsion of charges at rest. Charles Augustin de Coulomb discovered these laws and was the first to establish a way of measuring the attraction and repulsion of electrical charges. Coulomb began his work on electrostatic and magnetic forces in 1777, when he competed for a prize offered by the French Academy of Sciences for improvements in the manufacture of magnetic needles for maritime compasses. He immediately recognized that the conventional mode of needle suspension on a fine pivot would introduce frictional forces. To correct this source of error, Coulomb suspended the needle from a fine hair or silk filament. This led to the invention of the torsion balance, with which very small forces could be measured with great precision. Coulomb used the torsion balance during the years 1785 to 1789 to measure electrostatic and magnetic forces with great accuracy. The result of this work was his discovery of Coulomb's law, which states that like charges repel and unlike charges attract. This most basic law of electrostatics, of course, is also reflected in the atom, with the attraction of the positive proton for the negative electron, and the repulsion of positive proton from positive proton and negative electron from negative electron. Most materials are normally uncharged, which means that they have a balanced number of protons and electrons. They are neutral. If an atom gains or loses electrons, it is no longer electrically neutral. The electron's negative charges, or the proton's positive charges, will overbalance the other charge. An atom so charged is called an ion. An ion, then, is a charged atom, one that has lost or gained electrons. As electrons leave a material, the loss of negative charges leaves the material with more protons than electrons, and a net positive charge. An atom is called a positive ion if it loses an electron and will tend to attract electrons back to rebalance the atomic structure. If the opposite occurs, a negative ion is produced. If a material gains electrons, a negative charge will result. In other words, an atom is produced that has gained one or more electrons.